I've seen some of these Democratic governors say they're going to stand in the way. They're going to make it hard for us. Well, I you know, a suggestion: if you're not going to help us, get the hell out of the way, but we're going to do it. So if we can't get assistance from New York City, and I may have, we may have to double the number of agents we send to New York City, because we're going to do the job. We're going to do the job without you or with you. But it's much easier to arrest a bad guy. Like I just said, we're concentrating on public safety threats of human and national security threats. Right. It's much easier to arrest a bad guy in the jail. Give us access to Rikers Island that we've been kicked out of. Let us get the bad guy in the jail. It's safer for the alien. It's safer for the officer. It's safer for the community. But if you don't release these bad guys, if you don't release these bad guys out in the community, then we're going to have to go find them, which puts the officer at risk, puts the community at risk, and puts, you know, and bottom line is, it's no one, sanctuary cities are sanctuaries for criminals.
It's chilling what he just said. You realize that when he says, yes, families can be deported together, what he is saying is that U.S. citizens can be deported. What he is saying is, if the parent is undocumented and they have U.S. citizen children or U.S. citizen spouse, or they... And you don't want to separate them, then let's deport the U.S. citizens. Look, Donald Trump won the electoral vote. He won. He's going to win the House. He won the Senate. For all effects and purposes, he's got the Supreme Court. They've given him immunity. This is what the country voted for. This is, you know, a lot of people thought that when he talked about mass deportations, he wasn't being serious. I don't know how many times he had to say it for people to realize he was being serious. Well, if you thought he wasn't being serious, the appointment of Tom Homan today as border czar, and he will be in charge of a mass deportation program, the largest the country has ever seen, they say. And now Stephen Miller as deputy chief of staff should let you know that he was absolutely serious. And when you talk about mass deportations, people think, oh, it's just going to be the criminals. There's not enough criminals, aliens in the federal prison system for it to be mass deportations. What it means is grandmothers. What it means is brothers and aunts. Yep. What it means is abuelos y abuelas. It means dreamers. It means your family members. It means your colleagues. It means your friends. It means people who are part of the society. And look, America, you know, those of you who voted for Trump, this is what you wanted. This is what you voted for. You screwed around, and you're about to find out.
And there you have it, y'all. Anna Navarro and all of the wicked witches of The View and all their infinite wisdom, they have psychoanalyzed us. This woman says that we have made a mistake. We didn't know what we were doing. We were misinformed. And even though we are varied in our approach to politics, we don't think the same. We don't look the same. We are not of the same ethnicity. We are not of the same religious faith. We are not even in the same geographical location. We are spread far and wide. But on this point, we agree. No, this was no mistake, Miss Navarro. We know exactly what we voted for. And she's saying, your delivery guy is going to be deported. Your server is going to be deported. Your maid is going to be deported. Your gardener is going to be deported. Just like in the twinkling of an eye, you're going to look up and some folk ain't going to be here no more. Well, Anna Navarro, sorry to tell you, but it was intentional. We understood the consequences of our decisions. We understood the ramifications of our actions as we filled in that bubble. Something inside us went, you had to be there, Anna. And now that God has answered our prayer, we are even more excited, even more enthusiastic about what is to come for this country. You're not going to depress us, Debbie Downer. We know what you're trying to do, and we don't feel guilty not one bit. This is what we hoped for. This is what we prayed for. This is what we voted for, Anna Navarro. And if it take a little shimmy and shake to bring Americans of all different backgrounds together, then so be it, because unity is what we strive for in this country. At least one side. We trying to bring your side along, Anna, but you act like you don't want to come. You're kicking and screaming. Well, you got 4 years to think about it. But in the meantime, we gonna celebrate with a little shimmy and shake of our own. And y'all, this is dedicated to Anna Navarro. Like the video. Subscribe to the channel. and share the video so we can get more people involved in the conversation, y'all. And like I always say, always remember and never forget, without the gospel, it's just chops. Until next time.